Okay, we are going to differentiate sine x. Huh? Too easy? Don't worry. Let's go ahead and put this down right here. Yes, sine x factorial. So this right here becomes the derivative, and then we will have to use the integral definition for this. Namely, the integral going from 0 to infinity, t to the sine x power, okay? No kidding, okay? And then we multiply by e to the negative t dt. Aha, and then to differentiate the integral, we just put this inside and talk about partial derivative. So this right here becomes the integral going from 0 to infinity. Talk about the partial with respect to x. And then right here we have t to the sine x power and multiply by e to the negative t. And then right here, we put on the dt. And remember, in the x world, t is just a constant. So let's go ahead and first put this down right here. We have the integral going from 0 to infinity. So the derivative of this to that power is just going to be that. T to the sine x power repeats and multiply by ln of that, right? And then don't forget the chain rule. So multiply by the derivative right here, which is going to be cosine x. And then, of course, this is just a constant multiple. I'm just going to keep it as how it is right here. And that's pretty much it. But right here in the t world, we can just put the cosine x on the outside with this sine x factorial. And this is the question for you guys. Let's go ahead and do the derivative of sine of x factorial inside. Your turn.